فؤادك الأيام فت
والأصل في مياهنا الطهارة والأرض والثياب والحجارة. The author rahimahullah, he's saying here that the original essence of the water is purity. The asal is that the water is pure. What does he mean asal here? He means al-qa'idat al-mustamirra. The continuous principle is that the water is always pure. We will say that this water is pure unless there doesn't come إِذَا لَمْ يُوجَدْ دَلِيلٌ يُغَيِّرُ الْأَصْلِ, unless we find an evidence that diverts it from its original essence. Here we have to stop over something, which is the matters pertaining to this matter are four. The masail are four types. Matters are four types. And nawu al-awwal, the first matter is مسائل فيها دليل للتحريم أو النجاسة أو الفساد. We have to understand this in order to understand the issue of what is the asal of something. The masail in the Sharia are four types. Masail which are what? There's a dalil that it's haram, that it's impure, that it's corrupt. That's the first type. It is called مسائل فيها دليل للتحريم أو النجاسة أو الفساد. And based on what the evidence says, فَيُحْكَمُ بِذَلِكَ الدَّلِيلِ, the ruling of what the evidence is what we rule it by. The second type is what? مَسَائِلُ فِيهَا دَلِيلٌ يَدُلُّ عَلَى الْإِبَاحَةِ أَوِ الطَّهَارَةِ أَوِ الصَّحَّةِ. There is evidence that shows that it's permissible, that it's pure, that it's correct. The opposite to the first one. And because of that, فَنَحْكُمُ بِذَلِكَ الدَّلِيلِ, we will then also give it its ruling from the evidence that we have. Very good. The third one is what? مسائل يوجد فيها دليلان متعارضان. We have two evidences. Those two evidences oppose one another. Those two evidences oppose one another. دليل يدل على الصحة ودليل يدل على الفساد. There's an evidence that shows that this is correct, and there's the evidence that shows that this is incorrect. Or دليل يدل على الإباحة وآخر يدل على التحريم. Evidence that shows it's permissible and another evidence that shows it is impermissible. This one, فإذا لم يمكن الجمع, if it's not possible to bring them together, فلا بد من الترجيح. If we can't bring them together, then it's necessary that we what? That we have to choose. We have to run to أوجه الترجيح, to say that this one is stronger than this one. نعم. ومن قواعد الترجيح أن الدليل التحريم يقدم على دليل دليل الإباحة. And one of the principles which we will apply here, which is from the قواعد الترجيح, أما في أو or from the أوجه الترجيح. Tarjih means what? This one is stronger than this one. That's what tarjih means. One of the ways is to say that the dalil which is haram takes precedence over the dalil which is permissible. The impermissibility takes precedence over the permissibility. The fourth type. Masail, matters. لا نعلم فيها دليلا. We don't know any evidence for it. فهذه تطبق عليها قواعد الأصل. The asal is applied on the fourth type. You see? The asal, it is applied here. We start saying the asal of this is this, the asal of this is this. And that's the one we apply here. وَالْأَصْلُ فِي مِيَاهِنَا الطَّهَارَ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالثِّيَابِ وَالْحِجَارَةِ. The author, he said, وَالْأَصْلُ فِي مِيَاهِنَا الطَّهَارَ. The original essence of the water, it is that it's pure. Why would we say that? Because this matter of water, there is no dalil that we know that says it's impermissible, this particular water we have. Na'am? There's no evidence to say that it's permissible, or there's no evidence that says it's impermissible. Na'am? It's something that the Sharia went silent about. So we stick to the asal here. Does that make sense? Well, you stick to the asal. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he told us what the asal of it is. Fi Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 29, هو الذي خلق لكم ما في الأرض جميعا. Allah is the one who created everything on the face of this earth for you. And also Allah said, وَيُنَزِّلُ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً لِيُطَهِّرَكُمْ بِهِ. Allah sends down from the sky water so He can purify you with it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَأَنزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً طَهُورًا. We have sent down from the sky pure water. And also the Messenger said in the hadith, the A'immatu Sunan al-Arba'a narrated, Imam Malik narrated it, Shafi'i narrated it, Ahmad narrated it, Ibn Abi Shayba narrated it, Ibn Khuzayma Tirmidhi authenticated it, rahimahumullah, and it's the first hadith. Al-Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, rahimahullah, in his book, Bulugh al-Maram, he brought, which is that the Prophet said, Huwa at-tahuru ma'uhu al-hillu maytatuh. That the water is pure. That the water is what? Pure. In another hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-ma'u tahuru la yunajisuhu shay. The water is pure, nothing makes it impure. Nothing makes it impure. So the qa'idatul mustamirra is the asal, which is that the water in its original essence is that it is pure. Wal-ard, the earth as well. The earth, the asal of it is what? Annaha tahira, that is pure. Unless we know a dalil nahkumu bihi ala anna al-arda najisatun. Unless there comes a evidence that says, an evidence that comes and says that this water, this earth is impermissible, it's impure, we can't use it. Other than that, the earth is also tahir, it's pure to us. Where's the evidence for that? U'titu khamsan lam yu'tahunna ahadun qabli. I was given five, no one before me was given these five. And the Messenger mentioned from those five, وَجُعِلَتْ لِيَ الْأَرْضُ مَسْجِدًا وَطَهُورًا فَأَيُّمَا مُسْلِمٍ أَدْرَكَتْهُ الصَّلَاةِ فَعِنْدَهُ مَسْجِدُهُ وَطَهُورُهُ. Anybody, the Prophet said, I was given five, the previous nations that came before me weren't given these five. And the Prophet mentioned from those five, the earth was made a masjid for me and a pure land. The earth has been made pure for me and a masjid. Anybody who salah comes in, any person or any Muslim, the salah enters onto him, then verily the earth is a masjid for him and it's a pure place for him. The Messenger also said, alayhi salatu wassalam, alayhi salatu wassalam, as-sa'idu at-tayyib tahur al-Muslim, idha lam yajid al-ma'a 10 sinin. The Messenger said that the earth is pure, it is pure for the Muslim if he doesn't find water for 10 years, even 10 years. For 10 years you don't find water, you do tayammum. The author said, وَالثِّيَاب, and the clothing. The clothing, the asal of it is what? That it's tahir, it's pure. وَلَا يُحْكَمْ بِالنَّجَاسَتِهَا, and we can't say that the clothing is impure, إِلَّا إِذَا قَامَ الدَّلِيلٌ عَلَى أَنَّهَا نَجِسَةٌ. Unless there comes an evidence that says what? This clothing is what? It's impure. Unless there comes an evidence. Na'am. So the asal of it is that it is pure. And the dalil for that is the Messenger alayhi salatu wassalam and his companions, may Allah be pleased with them all. They used to wear clothing in which the disbelievers used to make. And that it was never heard that they would wash it before they wore it. So this shows what? فَدَلَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْأَصْلَ فِيهَا الطَّهَارَةِ, that the original essence of the clothing, it is that it's pure. وَالْحِجَارَةِ, and the stone as well. The stone. Stone is also pure. And it takes, for the author to take the stone out of it, it's because of the issue of what? The issue of when the person is doing istinja. But the hijara falls under the earth anyways. When he said, wal ardi, the earth, it's a naw' min anwa'il ard. So it takes its ruling. Na'am. Then the author said, al aslu fil abda'i wal luhumi wal nafsi wal amwali lil ma'sumi tahrimuha hatta yaji al hillu fafham hadaka Allahu ma yumallu. That's one version. Also, some say, فَفَمْ هَدَاكَ اللَّهُ مَا يُحِلُّ. Both of them are said. The author said, الْأَصْلُ فِي الْأَبْضَاعِ. The asal, so he's now told you the asal of some things that were tahir and that were permissible. Now he's going to talk about things that are haram in the original essence. Al-aslu fil abda', the original essence to the abda'. Abda' means what? It comes from the word bid'ah. Bid'ah means what? Qit'atu lahmin fi lughati al-arab. It's a portion of meat. That's what the word bid'ah means. But in the Arabic language, in the technical meaning in the Arabic language, it's used as three meanings. So linguistically, it means what? Qit'atu lahmin. That is what it means linguistically. Technically, the word means, according to the Arabs, it means three meanings. One is al-farj, the private part. The private part is the farj, it's a piece of meat. وَلَا شَكَّ أَنَّ الْأَصْلَ فِي الْفُرُوجِ, and the original essence of the private part is التحريم, impermissibility. فَلَا يَحِلُّ أَن تُسْتَعْمَلَ إِلَّا فِي مَا جَاءَ دَلِيلٌ بِحِلِّهِ وَجَوَازِهِ. And no one is allowed to use his private part in something unless there comes an evidence that permits it. So the asal of the private part, it is that it's haram, it can't be utilized except that which the Sharia gave permitted it. And the evidence for that is the statement of Allah, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ فَمَنِ بَتَغَى وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ. Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ the ones, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ the ones, لِفُرُوجِهِمْ their private parts, حَافِظُونَ, who safeguard their private parts. Who they safeguard for it? إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ, except their wives. أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ, or except that which their right hands have possessed. فَإِنَّمْ غَيْرُ مَلُومِينَ, those are not blameworthy. فَمَنِ بَتَغَى, anyone who tries to fulfill his desires elsewhere, وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ, after that which has been mentioned, Allah says, فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ, they are ones who have exceeded their limits. They have exceeded the boundaries that were set for them. So here, a matter that comes in here, which is the issue of masturbation. It falls under this point, which is the asal I'm sticking to is that it's haram. The asal is haram. You prove to me it's halal. Al-aslu fil abda'i wal-luhum. The asal of your private part is that you can't use it for what? For except what the Sharia permits. Rather, I can even prove it to you even more now that the Sharia made it haram. So the fact that I stick with the asal, which is that it's haram, until proven halal, so you have to go out of your way and bring me an evidence that says it's what? It's halal. And the Sharia came and it said that the only thing I have permitted is for a man to fulfill it with his wife, and for that which his right hand has possessed. And that's what Allah said in the ayah. Then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala rebuked those who try to fulfill their desires after that which has been mentioned. He says, فَمَنِ بَتَغَى وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ. And the fact that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said to the youngsters and the youth, he said to them, مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمُ الْبَاءَةَ فَلْيَتَزَوَّجْ. Anyone who is able to fulfill his sexual desires, he should get married. Who's able, financially can support the wife, and he's sexually, he is in need. فَلْيَتَزَوَّجْ. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطَعْ, the one who's not able. فَعَلَيْهِ بِالصَّوْمِ, for verily fasting is upon him. The Prophet never gave him no other alternative. The only option he was given after giving up on marriage, and he probably doesn't have the finance or anything for it, or is unable to get married, the Sharia has only given him one alternative, and that is the only alternative he can go towards, which is to fast. You see? Good. Also, the other evidence that shows that the asal of the farj is that it's haram is the statement of the Messenger that Imam Muslim narrated, that the Prophet said, اتقوا الله في النساء, fear Allah in the women. فَإِنَّكُمُ اسْتَحْلَلْتُمْ فُرُوجَهُنَّ بِكَلِمَةِ اللَّهِ. You guys have made their private parts permissible because of the word of Allah. Meaning Allah's statement allowed it for you guys. She was haram from you before. She became halal for you now because of Allah's words. Allah permitted it for you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he what? He permitted it for you. Then the ayah that I mentioned and the hadith, both of them, they indicate أن الأصل في النساء تحريم الفروج. That the private part of the woman, the asal is that it's haram. Good. The kalimatu bi kalimatillahi means what? The bi kalimatillah, there are aqwal that the ulama mentioned, but inshallah ta'ala, ala sahih, it is aqdun nikah, the marriage that Allah permitted, you're doing it with that. Good. So if the asal of the woman, it is, or the private part of a woman is haram, then a man cannot have intimacy based upon assumption and speculation. It has to be based upon what? Yaqeen. Naam. Because the asal is that it's haram and you're not allowed. The shak la yunbar. It is not looked at. The asal is what? Yaqeen that you are not allowed to. Naam. Number two, the scholars that said that the word abda'a, the word bid'a, the second meaning that they refer to it is what at it, or they refer to, or they said that it means is al-jima', intimacy. And intimacy, the first one was a private part itself. Now they said that intimacy is known as bid'a, and this is lazimun lil farj. Jima' is lazimun lil farj. Jima' is what comes after from the private part. So if we said that the private part, the asal of the furuj is tahrim, then what comes out of it is also going to be tahrim. There's no problem with that. That second meaning is there. The third one is aqdun nikah, the marriage. The what? The contract of marriage. Are you with me? Contract of marriage. Aqdun nikah. Some of the scholars, they talk, فَقَدْ ذَهَبَ بَعْضُ الْعُلَمَاءِ إِلَىٰ أَنَّ الْأَصْلَ فِي عَقْدِ النِّكَاحِ تَحْرِيمِ. Some scholars, they took the view that the asl of the nikah, the contract of marriage, the asl is that it's haram. Who saw that view? Al-Imam al-Suyuti, Jalaluddin al-Suyuti, in his kitab Al-Ashbah wal-Nadair. That's what he mentions. If you look at the Daba'a, Darul Fikr, page 44, that's what he mentioned. And other than him, from the people of knowledge. And that's what it seems like is the view of the author here. It seems that that's his view. From the line of poetry. And it also, he explained his own book, rahimahullah ta'ala. And from his sharah, it also seems the same. If you guys both go back to your sharah, the Shaykh AbdulRahman Nasir al-Sa'di, rahimahullah, he has his own sharah on this book, Qawa'id al-Fiqhiyyah. So it seems that he is inclined to that view as well. He's inclined to what? That view. That meaning is incorrect, or that view is incorrect. Because the asal of aqdun nikah is al-jawaz, permissibility. وَالْحِلُّ قَدْ يَأْتِي دَلِيلٌ يَدُلُّ عَلَى التَّحْرِيمِ وَدَلِيلُ ذَلِكَ عَدَدٌ مِنَ النُّصُوصِ الشَّرْعِيَةِ. Why is that a view that is weak? Because something that is permissible and evidence can come and make it, something that is haram, evidence can come and make it what? Halal. And so when it makes it halal, in that thing, in its originality, it becomes what? Halal. Because Allah said in the Qur'an, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, all those of you who believe, awfu fulfill al-uqood, the contracts, fulfill them. And nikah is an aqd. Uqud is a plural of aqd, contract. So the asal of any contract is permissibility. That's the asal for any uqud, any aqd, is that it's permissible. حَتَّى يَأْتِي دَلِيلٌ يَدُلُ عَلَى الْفَسَادِ وَعَدَمَ الصِّحَةِ. And that shows that this is impermissible. And that is not allowed. Also Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He said, حُرِّمَتْ عَلَيْكُمْ أُمَّهَاتُكُمْ وَبَنَاتُكُمْ وَأَخَوَاتُكُمْ إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْآيَةِ. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He said, these people are haram from you. And the fact that Allah exclusively mentions those who you can't marry, and the hadith also mentions those that you can't marry, what does that show? فَدَلَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ الْبَاقِي عَلَىٰ الْحِلِّ. It shows that the others are upon the original essence, which is permissibility. Allah also says it in another ayah, huh? Allah says it in an ayah, وَأُحِلَّ لَكُمْ مَا وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ. Allah has permitted for you anything after that. So everything else is permissible. The asal is that it's permissible, except these istithna'at, these exceptions that the Shari'ah has taken out. So, based on that point, we realize, we know, that أَنَّ الْأَصْلَ فِي عَقْدِ النِّكَاحِ, the asal of contract and marriages is what? al-jawaz, permissibility. Wal-hil, and that is allowed. Hatta yati dalilun yuharrimuhu. Unless there comes an evidence and makes it haram. The author also says, wal-aslu fil, he says, wal-luhumi, meaning al-aslu fil-luhumi is what? At-tahrimu. The author is trying to say that the original essence of meat is what? That is haram. And that is a madhab, a view held. It's a view that is held by some of the fuqaha. Some of the fuqaha, they hold that view. And al-asaf al-luhum huwa al-tahrim. That the original essence of a meat, it is haram. And the evidence that they base that on is the statement of the Messenger, alayhi salatu wassalam, which the Prophet said, إِذَا أَرْسَلْتَ كَلْبَكَ, if you send your dog, which dog have you sent? كَلْبَكَ الْمُعَلِّمِ, the dog which you trained. فَوَجَدْتَ مَعْهُ غَيْرُهُ, and then you find another dog with him. فَقَتَلَ فَلَا تَأْكُلْ, and the animal is dead. You told your dog, hunt the animal. Your dog ran to the animal. When you got there, you saw the animal that you told for it to be hunt on the ground, dead. Are you with me? Dead. Also what? Another animal standing next to it. Another animal next to it. The Prophet said, فَلَا تَأْكُلْ, don't eat it. فَإِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِ أَيُّهُمَا قَتَلْ, you don't know which one of them killed. Because if the trained one killed, it becomes permissible. If the trained one kills, it's permissible. Because when you sent him, you said, Bismillah. And you sent him. And is that your sword? When he went there, he killed the animal, you can eat it. Ah, but now you don't know if this other dog did the killing. So it is not permissible, the Prophet said. Don't eat it. Don't. And Imam al-Nasa'i rahimahullah, they narrated this and the hadith in its asal, it's in Sahihain, Bukhari Muslim. Very good. Naam. Sorry. The hadith Imam al-Nasa'i didn't narrate it. Bukhari Muslim, they themselves narrated. The hadith muttafaqun alayh. It's muttafaqun alayh. Ah, it is. So based on that, they said, that now the fact that there's two animals, then we go back to the asal, which is that it's haram. Kharit it. And they said the reason why it's haram is because you don't know which of the two killed them. It's... And they said it's like saying that an animal that comes from an animal which we can't eat and an animal that we can't eat, like the mule we mentioned last time, it comes from the donkey and it also comes from the horse. You can't eat it. Why? Because there is halal and haram mixed and you're not allowed to eat it. This issue doesn't fall under the issue of mas'alatul asl. Remember when we divided mas'ala into how many types did we divide it into? We divided it into four. We divided it into how many? Four. The fourth type, what did we say? It's masailu la na'lamu fiha dalilan. We don't have no evidence for it, right? The fourth one was what? Matters which we don't have no evidence for. Does this fall under the issue that doesn't have no evidence for it? No, it has an evidence for it. So for the Sheikh to say, al-aslu fil luhumi, it would have been correct if there was no evidence in it for it. And the matter does have evidence. Evidence that makes it what? It falls under the second type that we mentioned. Sorry, the first time that we mentioned, the first type. Which is مسائل فيها دليل التحريم أو النجاسة أو الفساد فيحكم بذلك الدليل. Anything that it's, there's evidence that makes it halal or that it makes it impure or it shows that it's corrupt. It falls under that. When we were talking about الأصل في مياه الطهارة والأرض والثياب والحجارة. We mentioned that. So for the author to bring it under there, it's not right. Not at all. Because we said مسائل الأصل, it is that which has no dalil in it. There's no dalil that makes it permissible, and there's no dalil that makes it haram. And this one there comes. وَلِذَلِكَ, for verily then, what is more apparent is that the asal of meat is halal. The asal is halal. The asal is what? It's halal and not haram. As we said before, like the water. The water, is it halal or is it haram in asal? The water is halal in its original essence. It's like mixing water with something that's halal or haram. What does it take? It becomes haram. If you mix water with something halal and haram, what does it become? It becomes haram. The same as if you've an animal, the dog you train and the other one, they both are standing there, You don't know which of them done it. It takes the same ruling. Did that remove from the water its original essence of permissibility? The same way they meet here. The same way they meet here. Na'am. Good. And the evidence to show that the meat in its original essence is permissible is the fact that Allah said, قُلْ لَا أَجِدُ مَا قُلْ لَا أَجِدُ فِي مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ مُحَرَّمًا عَلَى طَاعِمٍ يَطْعَمُهُ إِلَّا أَنْ يَكُونَ مَيْتَةً. Allah says, قُلْ سَيْ لَا أَجِدُ فِي مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ مُحَرَّمًا عَلَى طَاعِمٍ يَطْعَمُهُ إِلَّا أَنْ يَكُونَ مَيْتَةً. The Sharia only gave an istithna, exception from which one? Unless it's dead. It's a dead animal. Or in another ayah, Allah says, وَمَا لَكُمْ أَلَّا تَأْكُلُوا مِمَّا ذُكِرَ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَقَدْ فَصَّلَ لَكُمْ مَا حَرَّمَ عَلَيْكُمْ إِلَّا مَا اضْطُرِرْتُمْ إِلَيْهِ. So this ayah, what does it also show? أَنَّ الْأَصْلَ هُوَ الْحِلُّ وَالْجَوَازُ فِي اللُّحُومِ الْمَأْكُولَةِ وَأَنَّ التَّحْرِيمَ مُسْتَثْنَى. Those two ayahs, the first ayah was Surah Al-An'am, ayah 145, and the second was ayah Surah Al-An'am as well, ayah 119. So they both show what? That the Sharia gave an exception. It gave an exception that the only ones that are haram from the food and from food and meat is whatever the Sharia says. Na'am. That's what it is. Na'am. The other evidence that shows that the asal of the meat is halal is the hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Bukhari narrated it. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said that the Prophet was asked about the meat. التي يؤتى بها إليهم. The meats that are brought to the Prophet. ولا يدري, and they don't know. The meats that are, Aisha said, Ya Rasulullah, meat are brought. We don't know if Allah's names are mentioned in it or not. And they give it to the Prophet, he eats it himself. هل ذكر اسم الله عليها أو لا? Allah's name, has it been mentioned or not? The messenger said, سموا الله عليه أنتم وكلوا. You guys say بسم الله, eat it. And eat it. So what did the Prophet stick with? The asal that is halal, which is the certainty. And this fact that whether they said bismillah or not, it's doubt. We'll stick with the certainty and that it's permissible. You can eat it. Very good. Then the author said, he said after that, وَالنَّفْسِ. What does he mean by the nafs? He means al-aslu fi nafs. The asal regarding people's nafs, their soul, it's the fact that it's haram. You can't kill anybody. The asal is that the person, you can't touch them. A blood can't be spilt from anybody. إلا بدليل من الشريعة. Unless there comes an evidence from the Sharia that permits it. You can't transgress on anybody. You can't exceed your limits towards anybody. The people's blood is what? It is impermissible for you to touch. Unless there comes an evidence that permits it. And the evidence for that is the statement in the Qur'an that backs this qa'idah, this principle. Allah says, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Don't kill yourselves. إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا. Allah also says, وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. They do not kill the souls in which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made haram from them unless there's haq in it. Unless there's a haq in it. So you can't kill anybody unless there is an evidence that permits it for you. Also, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in the hadith Bukhari and Muslim narrated, لا يحل دم امرئ مسلم إلا بإحدى ثلاث الثيب الزاني والنفس بالنفس وتارك لدينه المفارق للجماعة. The Messenger said, it is not permissible the blood of a Muslim unless three situations. الثيب الزاني, the person, after going through marriage, he commits zina. وَالنَّفْسُ بِالنَّفْسِ, a person who killed another person. And the third one was, وَتَارِكُ لِدِينِهِ الْمُفَارِقُ لِلْجَمَاعَةِ. The person who kills what? A person, and the third one, which is a person who leaves the religion of Islam. And also the Prophet ﷺ, he prohibited the mu'ahid from the dhimmiyin to be killed. The disbelievers who have contracts, those who we have contracts in their lands. The Messenger said, مَنْ قَتَلَ مُعَاهِدًا لَمْ يَرِحْ رَائِحَةَ الْجَنَّةِ. Anyone who kills a person who has a covenant, who kills that person, the Prophet said he will not smell the fragrance of Jannah. So spilling blood is haram. Unless there comes an evidence that makes it what? Permissible. It makes it permissible. Na'am. For example, the magician as well, you can kill. There are other evidences that permitted. The Prophet said, Haddu Sahiri. The capital punishment, the punishment of the magician is Darbatun bi Saif, that he is killed. The magician is killed. As it's narrated in the Sunan. Na'am. Also, the Murtad, the one who apostates, he's also killed. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ بَدَّلَ دِينَهُ فَاقْتُلُوهُ. Anybody who changes his religion, kill him. Na'am. الْأَصْلُ فِي الْأَمْوَالِ. The original essence in terms of people's wealth is haram. People's wealth, you can't transgress on it. And you cannot what? You cannot exceed your limits regarding people's wealth. And the permissibility, many texts and evidences indicate that. That you're not allowed to exceed, you're not allowed to transgress on people's wealth. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَأْكُلُوا أَمْوَالَكُمْ بَيْنَكُمْ بِالْبَاطِلِ إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ تِجَارَةً عَن تَرَاضٍ مِّنْكُمْ. Allah says, do not eat each other's wealth based on batil, falsehood. Unless it's based on what? إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ تِجَارَةً عَن تَرَاضٍ مِّنْكُمْ. Unless it's based upon both parties are pleased with it. Both parties are pleased with it. Also, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, that Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, إِنَّ دِمَاءَكُمْ وَأَمْوَالَكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ حَرَامٍ. Your blood, your wealth are haram from one another. The author then said, the author says, Rahimahullah ta'ala, al-aslu fil abda'i wal-luhumi wal-nafsi wal-amwali lil-ma'sumi. For the person who is a ma'sum. Ma'sum is one, what? It is the one who is, it is, you're not allowed to kill. He's called a ma'sum. His blood can't be touched. But the ma'soom who leaves the usma, who is the one who leaves that, is the muharib, who fights with the Muslims. He's fighting with the Muslim. Their wealth, their blood becomes permissible when dealing with them. In a battle in which the two armies meet each other and they're fighting, then the wealth is taken from them and they're also fought against. Allah said in the Qur'an in Surah Al-Ahzab, Ayah 27, Allah says, وَأَوْرَثَكُمْ أَرْضَهُمْ وَدِيَارَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ وَأَرْضًا لَمْ تَطَأُوهَا. And Allah also said in Surah Al-Anfal, Ayah 1, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْأَنْفَالِ قُلِ الْأَنْفَالُ لِلَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ. Also Allah said in Surah Al-Anfal, Ayah 41, وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّمَا غَنِمْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَأَنَّ لِلَّهِ خُمُسَهُ. The Prophet also said, alayhi salatu wasalam, in the hadith Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, مَنْ قَتَلَ قَتِيلًا فَلَهُ سَلْبُهُ. Anyone who kills a disbeliever, anyone who kills him, he takes what that disbeliever is carrying. It's yours. He takes it. Na'am. And of course, it's all in a battlefield, not on the streets of a country or the roads. Na'am, it is in a place where there is a battle taking place and the Muslims and the non-Muslims are both fighting one another. Na'am.